I get edited and then put it onto the acid tape. And John said, how much will that cost? And Percy Phillips said, that would cost a pound. And John and Paul went white. And John said, there's no way we're paying a pound. That would have meant we would have had to each pay an extra 6 pence each. That's what things were like in 1958. But at least we paid and we made a record. And it's called, in spite of all the danger, which was Paul's first, the first song that Paul wrote, probably. And on the reverse side, there's a Buddy Holly number called That Would Be the Day. So we'd like to attempt, in spite of all the danger for you right now, thank you.
There's a bit more, yes.
Let's hear what Paul's got to say.
Song number two is the very first song Beatles ever recorded. Actually, this was pre-Beatles. This was John, George and myself and a couple of other guys, a pianist called Duff and Colin Hanton. And we went down to a little studio in Kensington in Liverpool, and we paid a pound each to make this little shellac recording. And the idea was that we'd keep it, each of us, for a week. So I had it for a week, John had it for a week, George had it for a week, and Duff had it for 23 years.
That's me. He says it was in his sock drawer, but I reckon it was in his underpants drawer. Story. I didn't know this, but whenever we went on holiday, my wife used to take it with us, stuck in the bottom of the briefcase. I didn't know, in the bottom of the suitcase, because she must have known it was valuable. I didn't, but there it was. You know, bless her. She took it with us in case we were burgled. I think.
Didn't he buy it off you?
he bought it off Doug. Like he buys everything out of them.
Made him an offer he couldn't refuse. I think.
Spite of all the danger, spite of all the
thank you.
to give it back to Paul tonight.
People are fainting.